Elizabeth.
You look so wonderful in your dress.
You came into my life at exactly the right time, when I least expected it. With some of the most difficult years ahead of me, you joined me on this journey and became the person I never realized I needed.
We are surrounded by all these lies and people.
For years, I have dreamt of this day. I have envisioned my fairy tale wedding since I was a child, but I never imagined in my wildest dreams that someone like you would be at the other side of the altar.
Should this be the last thing I see? I want you to know it's enough for me. So that you are.
You are my best friend, my soulmate, my go-to, my cheerleader, my supporter, and now my husband.
So in love. So in love. So in love, so in love. You look so beautiful in this light, your silhouette over me.
Today I'm the luckiest man in the world because I get to marry my best friend, my soulmate. As you know, I'm not one to open up and express my emotions. It took me longer than I'd like to admit and say that first I love you. But shortly thereafter, those I love yous became more frequent, and over time it turned into me saying I love you more.
Just say the word and I will disappear into the wilderness.
But I need you to understand that when I say I love you more, I don't mean that I love you more than you love me. I mean I love you more than the bad days ahead of us. I love you more than any fight we'll ever have. I love you more than the distance between us. I love you more than any obstacle that could ever come between us. I promise that I'll always love you more.
So in love, so in love.
The power of love is a curious thing. It makes one man weep, makes another man sing. It can change a hawk to a little white dove. More than a feeling, that's the power of love. It's strong and it's sudden, it's cruel sometimes, but it might just save your life. Yes, that's the power of love.
All of the voices surrounding us here, they just fade out when you take a breath. Just say the word and now we'll disappear into the wilderness.
We talk about the memories you have yet to make together and the moments you've already shared to be carried with you forever. But take the time to live today. As your marriage begins, look around and soak it up. The moment we are in now, for this is where the magic starts.
So in love. So in love.
Allow God to be the foundation of your marriage. So you have been chosen for each other. It is His plan. With each passing year, you will grow closer together, drawing strength from one another, and two shall become one. You will be blessed with the greatest happiness in life, which is to be loved and love in return.
Although we cannot see you, we know that you are here. We feel the warmth of your smile and the sense that you are near. And we want you to know your love is still our guide. Memories carried on in our hearts. You are always at our side. It is sad you will not be here on the day Elizabeth and Matthew skipped you. And so they say their vows today in loving memory of you.
I fell in love with you for many reasons, and those reasons were very clear to my friends and family right from the start. It was all solidified when one of the first and last things Nana told me was, "Don't mess this up, he's a keeper." Well, I think Nana is beaming ear to ear from heaven that I made it to the altar with the man whom she witnessed show an enormous amount of love and patience for me on a daily basis.
So in love.
As your husband, I vow to always support you, be your shoulder to lean on, and have an open ear to listen. I vow to always be a man of God and live in His presence so that I may continue to grow to be a loving spouse and someday a role model for our children. I vow to always make you feel just as beautiful on the inside as you are on the outside.
I vow that when times get tough, we try our hardest to remember back to this very moment on this day and why we made this commitment. I vow to walk alongside you in life and be your strength when you feel weak. I vow to forever date you as my husband and put in the effort into our marriage, always. Most importantly, I vow to choose you today and every day for the rest of my life. I love you to the moon and back and cannot wait to start the next chapter of our lives together.
It's now my sincere honor and heartfelt delight to declare you husband and wife. Matthew, you may now kiss the bride.
Ago, my parents were having a gathering at their house. Lizzie called me right before the party and said, I met this guy on Bumble. We went on a date last night. I really like him. We're probably going to get married, and I'm bringing him to mom and dad's tonight to meet everyone. That guy was Matt.
I've lost again, because it's clear to me that I've now lost the best friend competition. But I won't flip a table or search for a reset button, because this is the one time I'm happy to lose. Matt, I see you and Lizzie together, and I see love, but also true friendship. It's clear you've replaced me, and I couldn't be any happier to pass the torch. As your big brother, this is everything I could ever want for you. Let's cheer to love, friendship, to Matt, to his wife, and best friend, Lizzie.
Lizzie and Matt, may the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. May the rain fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you both in the palm of his hand.
So as a father, you always hope and pray that your children will meet the one person who will love them, share their dreams, and make their happiness a priority. My prayers have been answered today with the addition of Matt to our family. So welcome to the family, Matt, for better or worse.